You guys, Marty Schwartz here, guitarjams.com. I want to tell you real quick, you know, for people that are trying to learn guitar out there, you can sign my email list, the link right there, and I'm going to send you an ebook which has all the chords you're going to need, plus I send lessons that aren't on YouTube through that list, plus special offers. So if you want to sign that, you're going to immediately get that ebook, and I'm going to teach you this song right now. So this is a basic reggae beat, and it's pretty much all bar chords. So check this out. If you're going 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and every one of those counts, one is an empty space on guitar for reggae, unless it's the bass note, and that's what he does in the intro there. So, but what you want to start practicing, we're going to form an A major bar chord. So the root's on the 5th fret of the E string, index finger there, and then you play that. What this looks like, an E major shape, but this is in my ebook. So we've got the A major bar chord, and so if I was counting 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and, I only want to strum down on the ands. Check it out. 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4. So it's always going to be 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and it's going to really help to count that in your head. And also the best way to get the feeling, I found, it's also the most difficult for someone that's never played this groove before, is you got to count yourself off and then not play that downbeat. Watch. 1 2 3 4 1 2. See that? Everyone wants to go 1 2 3 4. And you get thrown off. So if you do it that way, it'll help you like right off the bat. But now watch this. This is what we want to add. We want to go like this. 1 2 3 4 1, and we're going to just hit the low E string, then a strum. So watch. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So that's the first chord. The next chord, we're going to just take this shape and scoot it up to the 9th fret, but then also take our pinky off, and that gives us, it's called a C sharp 7 chord. But so we've got A major, and we're gonna do the same thing where we hit the downbeat on that bass note. Then we're gonna take this same shape, and we just scoot it down a string that way, and that gives us F sharp minor. And if we put our pinky back down on the 11th fret of the G string, it just gives us a full F sharp minor chord. And you're gonna hit the bass note the same way we did with the first two chords, but on the A string. Then the 4th chord of the verse, the root's right there, slides down a whole step. And that's an E note, and then we form an A major shape. And all these bar chords are in my ebook. So ring finger covers the 9th fret of the D, G, and B. And we're gonna hit the bass note on that. So here's everything we got. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and, sorry, crap. Take 2. So here's what we got so far. It's basically, we call this the verse. Start with the A chord, bass note. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. Okay, the next section, we're gonna call this the chorus. We're gonna do this E major bar chord shape, and we just scoot it down and that's called a D chord, D major chord. Same thing as this. Same chord, but when we do the bar chord, we can cut the sound off, and that's what we want. So we're gonna do 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So we go 2 strums on D, 2 strums up a whole step, and then 4 strums on that F sharp minor chord from earlier in the song. Watch. And it does it again. Then on the third time, it starts the same way. It goes. So it does the D to the E, but then we have to scoot all the way up to the A major. And it's a little hard without a cutaway, but this is where it's going to be played. It's the exact same chord shape. Index fingers on the 12th fret. This is barred across the 14th fret. And we go like this. We hit that note and then a chuck here. So it's. Then just the index finger goes a half step down. Like that. So. Then that F sharp minor chord, bass note strum. Then the E. Then the D for 4 strums. Then that C sharp 7, which is the second chord of the verse. A billion air. And 1 strum on that F sharp minor chord, and then it goes into a drum fill back to the verse. There's only one other section that I would need to show you, and that would be what I call the second chorus, which is just 2 chords. You can play that reggae rhythm for everything. So let me play just that chorus one more time. Here we go. Third time. Okay, so after it goes through the form one time through, it's got just another chorus, and it's just F sharp minor for four off strums, and then now B minor, which is another bar chord in the E book. It's the 7th fret of the E string right here, and you make this look like an E minor, not an E major, no middle finger. That is the B minor chord. So the second chorus just goes. Those 2 chords. Those are all the sections of the song. I'm gonna play each of those sections one time. Okay, here's what I call the verse. Okay, here's what I call the first chorus. And then the next time through, instead of F sharp minor, B minor. You can see I'm ghosting those down strums, so I really feel it. You know what I mean? So that's a good start.